Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with the Java Server Pages in Web Technologies. In this video, I want to explain about the different tags that we are used in the Java Server Pages. Okay, so you call it as a syntax or you can call it as a tags also. In Java Server Page, Java code can be written inside the JSP pages using the scriptlet tags. So where you are writing this JSP, actually, you know how to write the Java code. Okay, so then in which place I need to be insert these JSP files? I have to write the separate, I have to create JSP file separately, and I need to call that files in the Java code, okay, or in the HTML. How it is possible? Let's see. With the help of the tags, you can create a JSP. In JSP, Java code can be written inside the JSP files. So inside the JSP files, you can return the Java code also. That can be called in the HTML program. Okay, no problem. Okay, so in JSP, the Java code, whatever you have created the Java code, that can be written inside the JSP pages using the scriptlet tags. So with the help of the scriptlet tags only, you are going to insert the Java code in JSP pages. Is it clear? See here. The scripting elements provides the ability to insert the Java code inside the JSP. The main use of the scripting elements. So I have so many scripting elements are there. In the JSP, I'm having three types of scripting elements. All these three types of scripting elements provides the ability to insert the Java code inside the JSP. The main aim of these scripting elements is to insert Java code inside JSP files. Inside the JSP files. If you want to insert the Java code inside the JSP files, you need to use the scripting elements. So let's see what are the three different types of scripting elements. One is a scriptlet tags, scriptlet tags, expression tags, declaration tags. So with the help of these three tags, you can insert the Java code inside the JSP files. So let's see first scriptlet tags. What is a scriptlet tag? The Java Server Page scriptlet tags. It is used to execute Java source code in JSP. So that what I said now. If you want to, it is the scriptlet tags are used to execute the Java source code which is present inside the Java server page. The syntax for is just, it's a percentile Java source code. Whatever the source code that you want to be print, that is a Java source code that you have to write inside these tags with the percentile symbol. So let's see a simple example here. To display a welcome message, I want to display a welcome message. How it is possible? By using the scriptlet tags. So one thing you have to remember that you are calling the Java source code. You are executing the Java source code in JSP. So HTML body. So this completely is a Java source code. How I confidently I'm saying it is a Java source code? Because here I using the out.print. Out.print is one of the printing writing statement. Okay. It is just a printing statement, writing or printing statement of Java. In the Java only, you are using out.print. I am using the Java source code in the JSP. So this is my JSP file dot, suppose a.jsp file. In this JSP file, I am executing the Java source code. That is out.print welcome dot welcome to JSP. So the what output I will get whenever I open this HTML page, the output I get is on the screen is welcome to JSP. So this is an output I am getting because it will print on the screen because I have written here is output out.print. Out.print is a printing statement of the Java source code. So let's take one more example to clarify your doubt on the scriptlet tags. So the Java scriptlet tags. So here I am taking two files. So let's see the difference. Here the example of JSP scriptlet tags that prints the username. I want to print a username. Whatever the username that I entered in the HTML browser, okay, in the browser, that has to print with some welcome message has to be print with username. See here, the file one index.html, HTML body, form action. So what action this page has to be done? The form action is welcome.html. So action, whenever I action, whenever you're keeping the action, means you have to compulsory keep the submit button. Whenever you click on the submit button, it has to perform the action. What action it has to perform? It has to go to welcome.jsp. Whatever the message that is there in the welcome.jsp, that will be print on the screen. Is it clear? Don't confused. Whenever the form action is there, action means whenever you are doing click on next or submit or whatever the clicking you are doing, you want to navigate to another page. Okay, so whenever the submit button is there, the action has to be performed. What action? It has to go to welcome.jsp. Whatever there that is in the welcome.jsp, that has to be printed along with this text that is present here. So here what text is present? Input type is equal to text. Name is username. So this uname that you are entering in this text box. So this is a text box. In the text box, I am entering, suppose, Bhanu. Okay, this is the text box. And the name I am entering, uname, is a Bhanu. Okay, so now I click on input type is equal to submit. So this is my page. Here the text name is there. Here I enter the Bhanu. Okay, and there is a submit button is there. On the submit button, the value I have written as a go value is there. So whenever I click on this submit button, that is a value, that is go, okay, it will go to JSP file. It go to the JSP file. So what is there in the JSP file? Let's see. In the JSP file, whenever I click on enter the Bhanu name in the text box and click on go, it opens another page. In this is a JSP page, HTML body. Here I am calling the Java server code. Okay, within this is a scriptlet tag. So in the scriptlet tag, I am calling the Java server code. What is the Java source code? Sorry, not server, source code. String name is equal to, so whatever the name I am using, that is the name is equal to request dot get parameter. Get parameter means whatever the value that I entered here. So I am requesting the server request dot get parameter. What parameter I want to call it? Uname. So that whatever I entered the parameter Bhanu, I am requesting. So that whatever I request, that message will be out dot print along with welcome. Welcome plus name. So that name is going to be added with the welcome message. So in this box, I'll print welcome Bhanu will come. So this is a message that is printing in the JSP file. I think, is it clear? It's nothing. It's a very simple. A programming concept is a very simple. You have to make it understand a step-by-step process. So this is my main page. Whenever I open this page, two fields will be appeared. One is a text box, that is a name is equal to uname, and the submit button. So whenever I click on the submit button, it has to do some action, that is welcome.jsp, it has to go. So what is there in welcome.jsp? So here I have written a source code, a simple source code, that is I'm just calling whatever the uname that I entered here. When I entered here, it goes to the server. Okay, I'm just requesting the server request dot get parameter. I want that parameter. What parameter? Whatever I entered here, that is a uname. Whatever I entered here, I'm just calling that parameter. And that parameter has to be print along with welcome. Welcome plus name. So that will be printed on the screen. Okay. So the index.html file gets the username from the user. The role of this program is, it's just gets the username from the user. I'm the user getting the username like Bhanu. Okay. And what welcome.jsp will do? Welcome.jsp file prints the username with the welcome message. So it just prints the message, whatever I entered here, Bhanu, with welcome message. So that is welcome Bhanu will be printed. So this is about the scriptlet tags. Thank you.